new way viruses could trigger autoimmunity discovered. Viruses are one of the most intriguing things on Earth. Many diseases like rheumatoid arthritis have been linked to viruses. But supporting evidence is scarce, so a research team investigated further. According to Johns Hopkins University, autoimmunity is the presence of antibodies and T cells directed against normal components of a person. The supposed defenders attack friendly cells because they perceive them as a threat. While it sounds exclusive, autoimmunity is more common than you think. If someone gets a very broad serum test, their results may even show some autoantibodies, despite being healthy. But because the regulatory mechanisms are working normally, these autoantibodies are unlikely to escalate things. But people living with autoimmune diseases have signs of immune dysregulation. Although the underlying trigger isn't exactly known, some theories suggest genetic changes while others link infection. At the Washington University School of Medicine in St. Louis, researchers conducted a study and discovered that a viral infection could set the stage for autoimmunity, even after the infection was resolved. Published in the Journal of Experimental Medicine, the team examined the impact of viral infection on T cells. Researchers analyzed the impact of murine roseolovirus in the thymus gland. Human and mouse roseoloviruses are under the herpes virus family. In people, roseolovirus can cause a mild childhood disease called roseola. Most people have been infected by this virus at least once, likely during their kindergarten days. However, roseolovirus doesn't really go away. It mostly stays dormant with a small chance of reactivating later in life. Roseolovirus was the center of this study because it's been suspected as a hidden culprit of autoimmunity. When the team worked on mice, they found that the newly discovered murine roseolovirus could do a lot. The virus could attack the thymus gland, the training camp of the immune system, where the best and most loyal T cells are selected. In the lab, newborn mice were infected with roseolovirus. After 12 weeks, all had developed autoimmune gastritis, a stomach inflammation, but no virus was detected in their stomachs. In a different mice group, the virus was treated early and no mice in that group developed a problem. A third group was infected as well, yet received a treatment later at 8 weeks old, and the problem still occurred. When roseolovirus attacked the thymus gland, future mature T cells developed targeting mechanisms against normal proteins. The sick mice also had antibodies against these friendly proteins. The likely conclusion is this: roseolovirus infection early might have created numerous defects that influence the supposedly original functions of immune cells. What's your take on the study? Do you believe that viruses can cause autoimmune disorders? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.